So for this lesson, what I'd like to do is go over this first example here. And then after I go over that first example, I would like you to try to pause the video and try the next two examples all by yourself. Because the most important part of watching these videos is getting the chance to try it yourself. Coming up on the Math Review. So this first example says 7 over 9 divided by 10 over 11. The first rule or step is to use KCF to create a multiplication problem. In case you don't know, KCF stands for keep, change, flip, where we keep the first fraction, we change our division to multiplication, and then flip our second fraction so the top becomes the bottom and the bottom becomes the top. So let's set up a KCF table. So the first column in the KCF table is for keep. So we're going to keep this first fraction, 7 over 9, exactly the way it is. The C stands for change, and what we're changing is division into multiplication. So let's write that here. Next, the F stands for flip. So the top is going to become the bottom, and the bottom is going to become the top. So instead of 10 over 11, we're going to flip this, and it's going to become 11 over 10. So now we go to rule 2, which is to multiply the numerators. Our numerators here are 7 and 11, because remember, the numerators are just the tops of your fractions. So this means I'm going to multiply 7 times 11, and that gives me 77. Now we'll go to step 3, which is to multiply our denominators. And in case you don't remember, denominators are the bottoms of the fractions. So our denominator in this fraction is 9, and our denominator in this fraction is 10. And since step 3 says to multiply our denominators, we're going to multiply 9 times 10, and that's going to give us 90. Then we can go to rule number 4, which is to just reduce if possible. That means that we would look and see if the top and bottom have some number that can divide both of them. But since that's not the case here, we're done, and our final answer is 77 over 90. So now that you've seen how it's done, why don't you try the next example on your own? But before you do, make sure you smash that like button. So example 2 says 5 over 8 divided by 2 over 3. Like it says in rule 1, we have to make sure we use KCF to make it into a multiplication problem. Now that we've set up our KCF chart, let's start with the first fraction, 5 over 8. Since that's in the K column, we're going to keep it exactly the same. Next is our C column, and C stands for change. And what are we changing? Well, we're changing this division into multiplication. So let's write that here. And last, in our third column, we have F, and that F stands for flip. So this 2 over 3 is going to flip and become 3 over 2. Then we can go to rule number 2, which is to multiply the numerators. The numerators in these fractions are 5 and 3, because 5 is the top of this fraction and 3 is the top of this fraction. So that's going to be 5 times 3, which equals 15. Next, we'll go to rule 3, which is to multiply the denominators. And in these fractions, our denominators are 8 and 2. And when we do multiply 8 times 2, we get 16. So this will be 15 over 16. And then we'll go to step 4. Which is to reduce if possible. But in this case, it's not. So we're done. And that means our final answer is 15 over 16. So now, Let's go on to our final example. 6 over 13 divided by 1 over 4. It doesn't matter how big or small the numbers are, as long as you stick with these four rules, you'll be absolutely fine. So rule number one is to use a KCF chart to turn this into a multiplication problem. So let's set that up. So let's start with our first column. We've got the fraction 6 over 13. Since it's in the K column, we're going to keep it exactly as it is. Next, in our C column, we've got the division symbol. And what we're going to do is change the division symbol into multiplication. And finally, in our third column, we've got the F for flip. So we'll take the fraction 1/4 and we'll flip it so it becomes 4 over 1. Next, we'll go to rule 2, which is to multiply the numerators. That means we're going to multiply 6, because that's the numerator of this fraction, and 4, because that's the numerator in this fraction. And 6 times 4 equals 24. Next, we'll go to rule 3, which is to multiply our denominators, and that's just the bottom of the fraction. And that means in this fraction, our denominator is 13, and in this fraction, our denominator is 1. So we've got 13 times 1, which equals 13. Now, the only issue with this answer is that it's an improper fraction. What that means is the top of our fraction is bigger than the bottom of our fraction, and we can't leave it like that. So we're going to have to do a little bit of extra work for this one. That means I'm going to have to scroll up a little bit. So what we'll need to do is see how many times 13 can go into 24. So we can write it as division like this. So how many times can 13 go into 24 without going over? Well, that would be one whole time. And 1 times 13 is 13. And when I subtract 4 minus 3, I get 1. And 2 minus 1 is 1. This means my remainder is 11. So my final answer is going to be a mixed number, where I have my whole number is this answer here. My numerator is my remainder, 11. And my denominator is my divisor, 13. So therefore, the final answer, or the quotient of 6 over 13 divided by 1 over 4 is 1 and 11 over 13. Now I know that last one was a real challenge. So if you got it, I'm really proud of you. And you should be proud of you too. Now if you found this video helpful, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe so you don't miss any more of our videos coming out soon. Thanks for watching.